What's up, everybody? Hollowtide here, and I just got done finally reading the entire article from PC Gamer about the Master Chief Collection. I've seen a couple of other videos done about this topic, and I kind of wanted to throw my hat into the ring while it's still hot, and I think that it honestly has legs for the next couple of months until we get to Halo Infinite. And just my opinions on it, and I would love to hear your opinions as well in the comments down below, because I think that it is actually important to talk about this. Before we get into the article, though, I do want to say that I think that this author is a super casual Halo fan, and there's nothing wrong with that either. I think that all player types are important to keeping the game ecosystem alive and well. Honestly, you have your super casual players, you have your regulars and your hardcore players, and I definitely think that the author falls into the very casual. There's also some points that they make that kind of contradict what they're saying in the first place, but we'll get into that as we go through the article. So the title of the article is, I wish 343 would leave Halo the Master Chief Collection alone. And in the subheader is, a fantastic time capsule is being transformed into an awkward and underwhelming live service game, which honestly I can already say that I highly disagree with. So the author starts off saying, why does 343 want to turn the MCC into a shoddy live service game? And they go around saying that the collection felt complete once all the games were finally on PC, and then says that 343 didn't see it that way, and that they started adding all the new cosmetic skins and stuff like that to the games. The author says that this cracks the time capsule, even though a lot of the armor is from other Halo games or even unreleased Halo armor in general, and that 343 doesn't entirely know what it wants to do with the collection, which, again, I would argue that 343 knows exactly what they're doing with the MCC. And while I agree that some of the armor from Halo Online and Halo 4 don't really look that great in a game like Halo 3, the option to toggle that armor is already in the game, so I'm not sure how really detrimental it is. They then go on to talk about the new map Waterfall and how ugly it is, which, again, I completely disagree with. I think that the map is probably one of the better looking Halo 3 maps, and I'm surprised that it's even functioning in the MCC in the Halo 3 engine. They talk about the battle pass that's included in the game and the leveling up system, and I don't really have too many comments on that just because I play the game enough to where I get the tokens. I'm probably more of a regular player in that tier list that we were talking about earlier, so I don't really have any problems with it. But then they go on to say that they're just being a weird Halo purist, and that 343 even added the new skin toggle to get rid of the designs that they added. And they say that at the end of the day, Halo plays like Halo, and that they don't care what the armor looks like in the first place. I think we can all realize that Halo MCC is the test ground for Infinite and what they're going to be doing in terms of the live service model for that game. And I honestly think that MCC deserves a lot of recognition for the amount of effort and time and work that they've put into it to create this amazing play space for people. And the fact that they're still adding new things to these games is, I think, a tip of the cap to the community. So all in all, I think that a lot of the points that they're making is, you know, kind of irrelevant to what's happening with the game. And I think it's just a weird clickbaity article that has no legs. And I believe 343 said that there's only going to be 10 seasons in the MCC, and that puts us right up at the Halo Infinite release date. So I'm pretty sure that once that happens, they're going to be putting a lot of their time and effort into the Halo Infinite content side of things instead of the MCC side. Hopefully we have the custom game browser and all that stuff finally. And I do believe we will, but I believe that MCC can coexist with Halo Infinite, and that the Halo ecosystem is going to be extremely strong going forward. If you guys enjoyed the video, make sure you leave a like down below. If you're new to the channel, make sure you subscribe, and I will catch you in the next one. Peace.